Welcome at the Wireless Classroom, where you can gather information about wireless systems along with coding examples. If you think this video is helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel, which helps me to produce more content. In today's video, I will explain the performance indicator called signal-to-noise ratio. The signal-to-noise ratio is defined as the ratio of signal power to noise power. Alternatively, you could use the signal amplitudes, which have to be squared for the signal-to-noise ratio. If the SNR includes random variables, as in wireless communication systems, the definition includes the expectation operator due to the fluctuations of these variables. For complex random variables, for example the complex channel, the absolute value of the random variables has to be used. Due to the high dynamic range of the signal power itself and consequently the signal-to-noise ratio is often expressed in decibel. In the figure, you can see a simple model of an additive white Gaussian noise channel. The transmit symbol X is transmitted over the channel H. At the receiver, we receive Y with an additive noise component. Thus, the received symbol Y is given by the channel convoluted with the transmit symbol X plus the additive white Gaussian noise. The signal-to-noise ratio is given by the transmit power multiplied with the average channel gain divided by the noise power. Note that in the denominator, we only include the signal power and not the entire received power, because this would include the noise itself. We call the expected value of the squared absolute channel the average channel gain, since it is the average scaling of the signal power incurred by the channel. This brings me to the end of this video and the performance indicator called signal-to-noise ratio. Thank you for watching.